Greetings, it's New Zealand naturopath Eric Backer, author of Candida Crusher and formulator of CanXida, the dietary supplements of choice if you've got Candida. Thanks for tuning into my video today. Today I'm going to talk about yeast infections, particularly the digestive system, antibiotics, and also a bit about probiotics. I've had many cases over the years where I've found antibiotics to be a real problem when it comes to people approaching me with gut disorders, small intestinal bowel overgrowth and Candida in particular. So that's what I'm going to talk a bit about today. I've had two cases today, both from America, which really concerned me, which is nothing unusual, but I get quite concerned with patients who routinely take pharmaceutical drugs and who present with yeast infections. But one case in particular was a young guy, now he's only 19, who took antibiotics on and off for several years for acne. And the other case was a case of a guy with major bowel dysfunction who'd taken triple therapy for Helicobacter pylori infection. So I'll talk a little bit about those cases later on. One thing that you need to bear in mind is there is not many more things more devastating for your digestive system than taking an antibiotic. I had the fortune to attend a seminar in Australia last weekend, presented by an amazing researcher of probiotics. You put a fantastic slide up of the Amazon rainforest. And then the next slide was basically barren. It was basically like a nuclear bomb had gone off. And what this guy said was, this is someone's digestive system after they've taken a round of antibiotics. So they can be devastating. And it can take years for your digestive system to recover from even a single round. So there are people, I think, that fall into three or four categories when it comes to antibiotics. One person, for example, will take, say, 7 or 10 days of penicillin for a strep throat and then recover 4 to 6 weeks later, or partially recover more likely because it takes a lot longer to fully recover. Another person will take a round of penicillin and take 1 to 2 years to recover. Another person may take a round of antibiotics and never fully recover. It's probably a bit like exposure, you know, to some poisons. Some people, you know, recover because they detoxify quickly and gain good health, and other people have never been well since, you know, a little bit of poison in their body. So everyone has their own ability, you know, to recover or not to recover depending on multiple factors, which we can't really go into today in this video. But what I want to stress to you today is you need to think twice before you take an antibiotic. They can be devastating. All too many patients I've seen take years to recover from 1, 2, you know, or 20 rounds of antibiotics. The poor young man at 19, you know, with the acne, I see this over and again of people who take these ridiculous drugs to cure acne. You know, they try and kill bacteria thinking that they can get rid of acne. What a stupid thing to do. And, you know, these people suffer for a long time. This poor guy's got leaky gut. He's got pain in his joints. He's got brain fog. You know, he's got constipation and diarrhea. He's got massive sinus problems now. So he's got all these multiple problems we have to fix. And guess what? He's still got acne. Isn't that stupid? Now, the poor guy with the Helicobacter pylori patients, a bacterial infection of the stomach, they typically take something called triple therapy, which are often two types of antibiotics. And sometimes they give an acid blocker as well along with that. I've given up trying to eradicate H. pylori. I went to a seminar in Sydney, Australia. I think it was last year I went, and I spoke with a gastroenterologist with about 40 years of experience who said to me, it's a waste of time trying to kill H. pylori. It's a complete waste of time. She said, you're better off modifying the patient's diet and lifestyle to build their immune system so this thing won't proliferate. Trying to get rid of Helicobacter pylori is almost impossible. And in nearly all cases, it will come back. If you're watching this and you've got Helicobacter, you may well have partially recovered. You would have felt great initially, but then you regressed and the symptoms came back. And what happens? Repeat testing and maybe another round of these ridiculous drugs. So it's more important to work on the milieu or the environment rather than it is to work on the pathogen itself. Louis Pasteur said that. You know, many very famous people have said that killing is not the answer. Making a person strong is the answer. Increasing their resistance is the answer. Not kill, kill, kill. We get nowhere with this stupid killing mentality. We've done the similar thing with wars in countries over the years. Killing the enemy is never going to win us the war. Certainly going to waste our resources and kill a lot of people, our own people, by doing these dumb things. So I hope the day comes one day when doctors realize that antibiotics are not really a good option for most people. They're necessary in a minority of cases, but they're used in such abundance. You know, we get them in the food chain, we get them in medicines. It's ridiculous. So if you're watching this and you're considering antibiotics, you know, for an infection, think twice about using this, because you need to think of the long-term consequences. You need to think about recovery. And if you haven't recovered because you've taken an antibiotic, keep watching, because I've got many more videos to explain how you can recover from the scourge of antibiotics. Thanks for tuning in.